and join Matt Block in full stereo sound only on WGRZ Stereo TV.
Welcome to the Critics' Corner. It's good to be back with this throat and time to catch up with some prominent and recent movies. Among the best was a sleeper of the summer, Stand By Me, unheralded, unhyped, and still going strong. Stand By Me is a story of four 12-year-old boys spending their final summer before entering junior high. This is neither saccharine cutesy nor growling with obscenities. The performances are fine, and their behavior, speech, and relationships ring with truth and memory. It's different from so many other movies about youth because instead of grossing you out, Stand By Me is engrossing. I must preface my views of The Name of the Rose by noting that I am a pushover for movies set in monasteries in the 14th century. That's exactly what The Name of the Rose is, a dark, foreboding mystery with Sean Connery persuasive as a Franciscan monk trying to solve a series of murders in a Benedictine monastery. The plot is intricate and the performances are admirable, with a special salute to Ron Perlman as a kind of babble-tongued Quasimodo. Not so successful is Lightship, a melodrama that would have been the bottom half of a double feature in the old days. Three gunrunners take over a Coast Guard floating lighthouse in a foolish plot that is worth sitting through for one reason only, to witness the performance by Robert Duvall as a psychopath dressed as a dandy and speaking in an accent that seems an attempted parody of William F. Buckley Jr. Without Duvall, this ship and its plot would have sunk at once, and even with Duvall's excellent eccentric performance, it barely stays afloat. Night Mother, that's a different subject. Night Mother is a gripping drama with a theme that is usually avoided, suicide. Sissy Spacek dwells with her mother, Anne Bancroft, on the outskirts of town and lives on the outskirts of life. She never leaves the house. Her travels carry her only from room to room, doing the washing, ironing, making beds, keeping Mama's candy dish filled. On this evening, when her totally dependent mother comes home, Spacek tells her calmly, even matter-of-factly, that later that night, she will take a pistol, go into her room, lock the door, and kill herself. At first, Mama thinks it's a joke, soon realizes that her daughter is determined, and the evening is spent with mother pleading, daughter being steadfast, and each revealing truths about their lives and feelings that they have never expressed before. Night Mother, intense, compelling, and heartbreaking, demonstrates again why Sissy Spacek and Anne Bancroft are Academy Award winners. Now here's the thing I cannot understand. I cannot understand the lines of people I observe waiting to see Blake Edwards' alleged comedy, That's Life. The acting is what we'd come to expect from Jack Lemmon and Julie Andrews, but I have grown weary of plots about cancer, men with a 7-year itch, and 60-year-olds wallowing in their mortality. Word from Hollywood is that the actors often made up their lines as they went along. Unfortunately, that is exactly what it sounds like. Next week in the Critics' Corner, Peggy Sue gets married, and Burt Lancaster and Kirk Douglas are tough guys. That's the Critics' Corner for this morning. Here is Nancy Foreman.
Thank you, Gene. And now here's a word from Pantene Shampoos and Conditioners. Serious care for beautiful hair.
Don't hate me because I'm beautiful. This is my hair in the morning. So I wash it, just like you. And blow it dry, just like you. So how come my hair looks great despite all this? I discovered Pantene.
Pantene's Pro-Vitamin B5 Complex penetrates your hair to give it inner strength, so it's healthier, stronger.
And it's always beautiful. Just like mine.
Pantene Shampoos and Conditioners. Serious care for beautiful hair.